Film theory in general examines how elements of filmmaking work together in order to tell a deeper meaning. It is in relation to aspects of reality and/or society.
Structuralist film theory is one that exemplifies the need to use codes. A common metaphor for these codes are called Easter eggs. There are hidden messages throughout the film that gives the film a deeper, more conceptual understanding.
Structuralism was first introduced into the film studies in Britain as well as the United States towards the end of the 1960s. Structuralism was first centered in France during the mid-60s because many took an interest in reading objects through the concept of structure. So in terms of film, this was how the audience was able to read and understand the signs that were presented within a film. An important aspect of structuralism was semiotics, which is the study of signs and symbols and their use or interpretation. Therefore, it was favored by many structuralists like Ferdinand de Saussure, and in 1916 he published the Ferdinand de Saussure's Course in General Linguistics, which was compiled of lectures by his students. And this was very highly influential because it set the basis for modern linguistics and semiotics. And so structuralist linguistics is normally seen as giving rise to those independent American traditions. Now, semiotics has three levels. The first is syntactic. And this is the formal properties that the signs or symbols have. So in film, this can be dialogue that a character speaks or sounds that you may hear. And the next is pragmatic. And this is concerned with like relationships between those signs or anything that is expressed by the characters. And then last is semantic. And this is actually the relationship between those signs that are present in the film and what meaning they are trying to create or what meaning the audience gathers from it. However, these three levels can also be referred to as the sign, the signifier, and the signified. Now, in terms of structuralist film theory, semiotics uses concepts of codes, which can be technical or structural, to discuss conventional ways that meaning is being created in film. So these codes are normally cultural phenomena that are being learned throughout history. And so this therefore places emphasis on the genre conventions, narrative theories, and codes and patterns that are recurring throughout films. And all of these things are actually helping the audience to understand what's going on. And one example of a recurring story pattern is the plot structure, and this is because plot structures are a defining characteristic of a genre. Furthermore, cultural codes can be things like gender or someone's social class or authority, and this therefore reveals like their cultural beliefs in those areas. An example can be the Hitchcock blonde, who represents gender and class and sexuality. And along with cultural codes, there are technical codes, which are the way we have learned to read the visual information that is presented on the film screen. And this is because these have thematic implications. So in terms of a tilted composition in a scene, this can sometimes suggest a character's feeling uncertainty or implying that there will be danger. These technical codes also include point of view, reaction shots, and a montage. And actually, a Soviet filmmaker by the name of Sergei Einstein believed that montage was one of the most important aspects because the structure of the montage enables the audience to actually gain that meaning from the film. And one very famous technical code that's used in structuralist film theory films is the Kuleshov effect, which is the juxtaposition of shots, which can actually alter the meaning that the audience gains from the film.
Sergei Einstein was a Soviet filmmaker who believed that montage was one of the most important aspects of a film, and it enables an audience to garner more meaning from a film. As one of the major characteristics of structural film theory is using various shots to convey codes, Einstein's theory was impactful in structuralist theory and film semiotics. This theory also prompted the introduction of the Kuleshov effect, coined by Lev Kuleshov in the 1910s and 1920s, which states that the same piece of film can have the same meaning based on footage put before or after it. Many directors use elements of structuralist film theory in their films and is a useful lens to view a film through in order to understand possible deeper meanings or find interesting Easter eggs.
Easter eggs. In film, an Easter egg is a term used to describe a hidden message, image, or feature. For instance, in Pixar films, no matter how you slice it, the Pizza Planet truck has become an iconic Easter egg for Pixar fans to find. It's found in about every Pixar film, either tucked away in a scene or sneakily right in front of your nose. The Pizza Planet truck was first introduced in 1995's Toy Story. The truck isn't hidden in Toy Story, it is a part of the plot to get Buzz and Woody to the Pizza Planet restaurant to reunite with their owner, Andy.
Now, you're sure this space freighter will return to its port of origin once it jettisons its food supply?
Uh-huh.
Well then, let's climb aboard.
No, wait, Buzz!
After that, the Pizza Planet delivery truck, which is a yellow truck with a rocket on top, has worked its way through almost every Pixar movie since, such as The Good Dinosaur, Brave, Wall-E, Up, and even Monsters University.
A film that also uses Easter eggs is the movie Coraline, directed by Henry Selick. Coraline has many hidden meanings throughout the film that can be shown through the mise-en-scene and through the use of cinematic techniques such as lighting and shadows. These hidden gems in the movie serve as the codes that are crucial when looking at the structuralist film theory. In this scene, the other mother and the other father are putting Coraline to sleep.
I think I should get to bed.
Of course, sweetheart. It's all made up.
But...
Come along, sleepyhead.
Through the use of lighting, a shadow of the other mother is seen on the wall. However, the shadow is shaped like the other mother's true form, a tall, slender, spider-like figure, not the perfect version of Coraline's real mom that she claims to be. This code is a perfect example of how the creators were able to use the cinematography in the foreshadow of the other mother's true identity. Another scene that stresses the need to look through the structuralist film theory lens is the mise-en-scene of the scene where the other mother gives Coraline a cake upon her arrival in the other world. The words on the cake read, "Welcome home," in cursive. However, if observed closely, the letter O has two circles in it. According to graphology, a double loop on a lowercase o means that the person who wrote it is lying. There was one double loop only in the word home and not on the word welcome, meaning that she is welcome, but she isn't home. These scenes are just two of many that are used to demonstrate the structuralist film theory.
Another film that uses structuralist film theory is The Joker. The Joker is a semiotic film not only because of its sustained use of long shots, but also its codes for a larger societal impact. The film also explores mental health and masculinity through the character development and backstory, serving as a code for a larger societal message. This is exemplified through this scene, in which we see three men harassing a woman on the train by making unwarranted comments towards her, something that is characterized by many feminists as a result of patriarchal power structures and toxic masculinity. At first, we see the Joker laughing, but when the men turn their aggression towards him, he kills them. Viewing this through the structuralist film theory, we can view the three men as a code for toxic masculinity, and that the Joker killing them is symbolic of him rejecting this, or only rejecting it once it has harmed him. Structuralist film theory doesn't just need to be about Easter eggs, but we can use this theory to see events as code to better understand social commentary on today's world.